Hello, my friend, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to start off with Bases Loaded Lacquer Shutout and Look Nail Lacquer Pistachio and White and Dance Legend Spot It in Red and Blue. Here is Look Polish, and this is Pistachio. It's turning more yellow as it gets older, but it's okay. And this is the White from Look Polishes. I've also got these Dance Legend Spot It's in Blue and Red. We're going to do some sail fluid art today. I've got out a piece of just parchment paper from the kitchen. I thought I would give this a try. I know not everybody has those little silicone mats, so I'm going to do them in a couple of different ways today. But I put out a spread of white, and I'm going in with the pistachio color from Look. And I'm just doing little drops or big drops, medium-sized drops, all over the white polish that's been laid down. And then I'm going to put in some more white. And I'm sorry my hand's blocking it, but, you know, I can't be messing with the camera while I'm doing this stuff, so I can't change positions. We're just going to have to roll with it today. I am happy to announce that this experiment worked quite well, and I really did like using the parchment paper. Now you can see I've already jumped into the Spot It polishes. These are the special polishes that form sails when you do these kind of designs. It's got a magic in it that makes the polish separate and create those cool little sails that we like. You can see it right there in that corner with the red really well. It's got several, you know, spots in it. And we're going to just, now I'm just kind of filling in and doing drops of all of them. Just keep going over it. Okay. Now I'm going to fold the paper over, smush it. And then look at that. Okay, I'm going to pull it up closer. You can see all those little circles and cells. It's kind of flowing. Now I'm going to do some on the mat, but I'm just going to drop the drops like on top of each other. I did a regular white, and now a blue Spot It, and then a pistachio, a bigger pistachio. And then we're going to do the red, and I'm just going to, you know, add drops until I think I've got enough polish down on that mat. And this is one of the ways. You can take it and you can mush it and give it a little shake. I'm going to tap it, let it roll down. I like to do that because I want the thickness of the polishes to kind of be even. It doesn't always work so great for me, but look at those cells. Ah! All right, so we got another silicone mat out. And you don't have to have silicone mats to do this. You can do it, you know, on a lunch baggie or a, you know, like a Ziploc freezer bag or whatever, you know. I'm doing the same thing with this and doing all the drops in the same spot, you know, on top of each other. But I'm going to use the stamper to disperse and squish. So here we go with an old stamper. And I just mush down. And then you get two. You got one on the stamper. It's kind of separating. You can see there's separation. And then there's going to be one on your mat. So you get two out of that. And we're going to just keep on playing because I'm having so much fun. I'm going to do this again over in the corner. And I'm doing this one the same way. I'm just playing. And I end up using different ones. I use some from the wax paper, some from the folding over on the mat, and some of these from the stamper when I finally put them on my nails. I just kind of mix it up. And see, you can see it's separating on that stamper. Maybe that stamper needed to be washed before I used it to make sure there was nothing on it. I am going to roll over these images, all of them, with some of the Wet n Wild Clear. This isn't really a top coat or anything like that. It's just a clear polish. And this one works great for decals and you know, things like this, because it stays more pliable. I would not recommend using a fast dry top coat at this stage on your decal making. They dry too fast and they kind of curl up and shrink. It's just the nature of a quick dry polish. So there we go. Alrighty. So now that they're totally dry, they dried for like a whole day. I'm going under it with a tool and just a cuticle tool, and I'm peeling it off the paper. Look, it came off perfect. Okay, so here we go with bases loaded lacquer shutout. It's got the old label on it. I do have nail teaks already on my nails, and we're gonna apply a coat of shutout on all the nails. This way, if something doesn't get covered or there's a hole in it or whatever on my decal, then there's something underneath it. It's not just, you know, naked nail or negative space or whatever. And you can see this is a one coat wonder. Look at that. Beautiful. I am going to cap my free edge out of habit. Okay, I am going to top this with INMs out the door. I did have to get Woody out there and clean up a little mess on that fingernail, but it was tiny. So I didn't bother showing it. I'm going to cap my free edge with the top coat as well. And here is a photo of shutout on its own. Beautiful. And I'm going to take my little nippy scissors. That's what I call them. They are actually thread nippers, I believe. I think they're in my description box if you're interested. And I'm just cutting them down to kind of like nail size. There will be overhang. I'm just kind of picking out different areas and kind of cleaning them up. And we'll see what I end up using. You just never know. And to be honest, I should have gone over these again with that Wet n Wild clear top coat to kind of rehydrate them a little bit and then let them dry down just a little bit before I tried using them. We're going to get another piece off of this one. And get them on the nails, because they were a little bit harder to get on the nails because they were starting to get a little more stiff. So if I had it to do again, I would have kind of recoated these with a little bit more juice, as you know, the Wet n Wild. So just trimming them down. I like to do this. It helps me position them on the nail better, I think. So you can see I'm just cutting out a bunch of little pieces, and we'll see what ends up landing on them nails. Some of these were really, really cool looking. Alright, so I'm going to be using IMK's Bio Base, and this is the sticky Bio Base, to help these stick down to the nail when I apply them. And I'm not doing like a really thick coat because I don't want it sliding around all over the place. But I did get all of the nail coated in that. And now I'm going to stick it down, and using my fingertips, I'm just going to press it down. Try to make sure it's adhering to the nail a little bit. Break out those little nippy scissors that I can use with my left hand. And do a little bit of extra trimming. Not too much, because I don't want to mess up and cut my nail. And then some more mushing with the finger. Alright. I am using my cuticle tool, and I'm going to try to break off, cut off a little bit of this excess overhang. And I'm also pushing the decal onto the nail with that tool. And with my fingers some more. Fingers are great tools when you're doing nail art. I'm going to go in with my acetone, and I'm going to try to melt this decal down to the sides and around the cuticle area and across the tip of the nail. But doing that little dab, dab, dab helps melt it. It melts that polish down to the polish that's underneath it, and it sticks together pretty good. And now I'm doing some swipe cleaning. Gotta get that dampened dish out of my way before I make a mess with it. You can see I'm kind of dabbing and brushing. Got some across the end. I use the flat side of my brush for that. Seems to work pretty well. And there is a spot on this nail, it's very close to the tip, where you'll see that white, that shut out, sticking out from underneath it. And that is why we do that, because you want to have at least something there. And there was white in with my fluid art, so, you know, it could have just been a spot from that, for all you know. Doing a fine-tuning cleanup around that cuticle area. I always go underneath also. I don't like big blobs of nail polish up under the nail. It worries me. So now that that is done, I'm going to top these with some Posh top coat. Seal them in and make them all glossy. I really enjoyed doing this one, but it was not my favorite fluid art manicure I've ever done. But, you know, it's been a while, and I needed the practice for sure. Hi, Woody. How you doing? Thank you. There's my swatch photo. I hope you enjoyed this one. Leave me a comment down below. I want to thank you for watching. Until next time, be good to yourself.